The skies darken, and there's a stirring force over the Atlantic. With Hurricane Lee on the horizon, we're about to dive into the science, history, and naming conventions behind these aquatic titans. What is a hurricane? At its core, a hurricane is an intense tropical storm with winds exceeding 74 miles per hour. Born over warm ocean waters, these storms gather moisture and energy, culminating into cyclonic powerhouses that can wreak havoc over land. Lee's evolution and trajectory, from its genesis near the Cabo Verde Islands as Tropical Depression 13, the impending transformation of this storm into Hurricane Lee showcases the capricious dance of our weather systems. The naming saga. Hurricanes aren't randomly named. They're christened by the World Meteorological Organization using predefined lists, cycling alphabetically each year. If a hurricane particularly stands out due to its destruction, its name might be retired out of respect for its victims and to prevent future confusions. Deciphering Destruction, enter the Saffir-Simpson scale, which ranks hurricanes from categories 1 to 5. With Lee threatening to attain category 4 status, we're looking at potential catastrophe 1 that can alter coastlines and disrupt communities. Brewing a hurricane, the concoction for a storm requires a blend of rich moisture, gentle wind shear, and waters heated to around 26.5 degrees Celsius, reaching down to a depth of 50 meters. Climate change, the intensifying factor? The debate around global warming's effect on hurricanes persists. Current discussions suggest a possible 10% boost in a hurricane's destructive prowess for every 3 degrees Celsius rise in sea temperatures. Regions in Lee's crosshairs, using historical data and current trajectory insights, the Atlantic Basin emerges as a focal point. Hurricane Lee, with its foreboding presence, accentuates the whims of our dynamic planet. Our best shield? Understanding the storm's nuances and prepping for its power. If you find yourself on the eastern U.S. coast, Gulf of Mexico, or the Caribbean islands, it's prudent to stay alert and informed.